Google just killed UI design with a Google Stitch. Well, at least that's what the clickbait would say. But let's slow down for a second. I've been running UX design and design thinking workshops for over 20 years now. What tools like Google Stitch bring to the table is okay, but it's not a replacement, not even close. So this is Google Stitch, a brand new AI-powered UI designer straight out of Google Labs. It's basically like a ChatGPT, but for interface design. You describe what you want and it builds full layouts in seconds. So, should designer panic? No, seriously not. So it looks nice on first glance, and I'm pretty sure there are a lot of influencers will ride the hype train. But from what I can see so far, it's really more like basic layouts, nothing fancy, and most importantly, it doesn't solve any problems. Normally, when you think about a product design, it's all about problem solving, which means we need to talk a lot with our team, with POs, with the user. We need to work with real problems. Everything what tools like Stitch can do, or even the Figma own AI design builder, is giving you some random layouts. It's not even better than what you would get when you just do a random search on Pinterest, Dribbble, or all the fancy platforms. In some cases, if you're a product designer, you've maybe already prepared a good design system, which includes also already templates, which can be edited way faster than what you could do with Stitch, at least right now. No panic. Let's do a small deep dive into Stitch and how it integrates with Figma. The first thing we do is we just give it the prompt after we're visiting the site. And what you see is similar to what you may know from any other AI chat agent. So, design a fitness app including the flow. Let's see what Stitch does with this random prompt. Okay, he already answered, asked us some questions. He tries to confirm that this is a flow he should create. Let him create this flow and see how it works out. First one. Join the fitness revolution, FitQuest. Oh, that's actually nice. Sign up via email, continue with social, log in. I would never design a login screen like this. But it's okay, it gives us already an idea what we could do. I guess it's better than a blank screen. And then it prepared already some of the other screens. One thing we need to understand is this is kind of my 10th generation with Stitch, and all the layouts look really, really similar. Most UI AI tools, there's kind of a design system in the background, and the AI tries to grab the components out of this design system to create whatever we ask it for. This normally works quite well, but it ends up in a rather redundant flow of screens. In this case, I see already that it used exactly the same components like in my last try. And it's okay, it's a good starting point for us. What is nice, we can also say, hey, give me something more like this custom color. Yeah, make it a little bit more poppy. And I would like to have a light version of it. And maximal roundness sounds good. Apply the theme. And then it applies the theme, which means it will now generate new screens with the light or dark mode, as well as our selected color and the border radius. So it's quite similar what we can see in Figma right now. If you generate layouts via Figma, and the quality is also rather similar. So there's nothing fancy or special about it. Meanwhile, we can grab our first screen, clicking here on Figma, and then go to Figma, copy paste our design, and see what it produced. So what is nice is Stitch tries to already group the elements. Therefore, it uses also auto layout, which is pretty cool. OK, Okay, let's try to edit the screen. Can you add a trophy? Trophy collection and an edit profile button. Let's see what happens next. Okay, it generated a new version with trophies. Yeah, it's just boring. Like mentioned, you can generate a first draft to take it further from there on. But I don't think that you generate something with it and it will be beautiful and great. It's similar to what you can do with a Canva. You can easily create some posters, some flyers with Canva or business cards. But in the end, it's not what we designers do. It's mostly for people who are not able to design on their own. And let's be honest, all of those people would probably not hire a designer in the first place. No, don't get me wrong. I am not anti-Stitch. For early ideation, it's awesome. Think of it like the AI version of your sketchbook. You can use it to explore layout directions together with your stakeholders before committing to anything, which should speed up your design process. You still need to adjust the screens. You need to work with it to make something out of it. So instead of scribbling boxes on paper or hunting through Dribbble, you get instant layout ideas to jumpstart your thinking. But the moment you step into a real product team, tools like Stitch just hits a wall. Most products already have established design systems, component libraries and patterns that everyone's aligned on. You can't just drop a Stitch-generated UI into your app and ship it. It won't match the tokens, the accessibility constraints, or the user flows. Just to empathize on the point here. Stitch is a nice tool, but it will never, never replace a designer. So don't be scared. Try to use it, try to incorporate it into your daily work. Then maybe it's a useful tool for you, maybe not. For myself, I don't see any value in it, because for most things I've already prepared a huge design system, which helps me a lot to work on my projects and partner projects. I'm really curious to hear what you think about Stitch. Does Google Stitch scare you or excites you? Drop your thoughts in the comments. So, see you on the next one.